My channel today I have my cousin Shalia and we're gonna do a mukbang. So we have random questions that people submitted and random questions from the internet. So we're gonna eat our seafood. I think we need to show them. Yeah, I want my butter to fall.
Is this gonna be a thumbnail?
Sure, thumbnail. So we got random questions, so we're gonna jump right into the video. All right, number one. When did you screw up something but no one ever found out?
Every day. No one ever found out?
Yeah, but you screwed it up but nobody found out.
Well, I just dropped like half a thing of highlighter on Quan's floor.
And he don't know?
Mm-mm. And I tried to hurry up and get it up, so I was going like this.
Hey, Quan!
It was a tornado of glitter in the air. Like, he didn't see me.
I screwed up, but they found out later, but they didn't really know.
Well, that don't count, because that's not the question.
And nobody ever found out.
But they always find out with me. That's the only thing I got away with.
The only thing I can think of is when I messed up during the cheerleading competition thing. I was supposed to be going one way, and I was going the other way, and it messed up everybody's. And they didn't know what was wrong or why everybody messed up until after. And they was like, Vshara was going the wrong way. That's all I think about. What celebrity would you rate a perfect 10?
A perfect 10?
Oh my god. You didn't get
if you hear people in the background, this is just a ratchet mukbang. Sorry.
Who do you think is a perfect 10?
Who I think is a perfect 10?
I'm pretty sure you don't know him, but he's a singer. Slash rapper, his name is Lucky Day. He's like a perfect 10. She's gonna insert a picture right here.
Perfect 10. I'm gonna pick a girl. Her name is Beyonce. And she's like a perfect 10. And I'm gonna insert a picture right here. After a breakup, would you rather be alone or surrounded by friends?
Alone. I need my Netflix.
I think I would rather be surrounded by people to keep my head off of things.
I should start watching sad movies. I don't know why sad stuff make me get over stuff. Like, you gotta listen to sad music, you know, to get it out your system. And then you can bounce back with some Meg Thee Stallion, you know, Trina, City Girls.
Oh yeah.
Act up if you need to. Why you got so many potatoes? Mm-hmm. They dry. Sushi? You want ham with the minced garlic though. You see it?
Alright, would you rather be rich or famous?
Famous? Then I can make money and be rich?
I think the same. No, I'd rather be rich because then people won't know. They won't know that you have like money.
But yeah, you got a YouTube channel.
I'm saying, no, I'm just saying, like, what if I had like money, long money? Nobody would know, like, just randomly know.
So you telling me?
I could go up to the mall and nobody would know that I'm rich.
Have y'all seen Vshara's house tour? She don't want nobody to know she rich.
Check my bank account. Then tell me if I'm rich.
YouTube channel.
Nice house.
Don't want nobody to know you famous or rich.
If you could turn into any person or being, what would you be?
I would want to be like an animal. Don't you say?
A person or a being.
Oh. I want to be Oprah, but with a man.
Oprah got a man.
Stedman. I feel like Stedman for everybody.
We got a lot of people in the background who don't want to be videoed. Anyways.
I do.
I think I would want to be... Again, probably Beyonce. Not because of Jay-Z. Ew. I can get rid of Jay-Z if I'm Beyonce. But just be Beyonce for a day.
So if you was Beyonce, who would you replace Jay-Z for?
Ooh. Hmm. Replace Jay-Z for? Probably like a Morris Chestnut or like a, somebody like that along those lines.
Them low budget films.
But Morris is fine.
He's fine, but he ain't on her caliber.
But who is?
Morris got money. Morris got old money.
Yeah. Like Mike?
The last holiday? The last holiday. The best man's last holiday.
If somebody gifted you a two-person vacation on a tropical island, who would you go with?
That's funny. I'll probably go with Pato, no lie.
Just two people.
I mean,
hold on, gifted you a two-person. Okay, okay.
Don't that count for me too?
Oh yeah.
Oh.
She would take me.
This is hot, by the way.
To a tropical vacation.
You ain't gotta take me, it's okay. I was just saying. It's okay. Shout out to Brie. Shout out to Melody.
No. Shout out to Samaria and the other girl that you go to Vegas with and everybody else. Oh, I get two little friends.
Wow.
I probably would take her. I'd be like, hey, I just want a trip. Yeah, I probably would take her.
Are you recording this?
Right. Recording myself mine.
Ooh, this is kind of deep. What would you write in your grave?
It was lit.
It's lit. I tell you, my soul conquered.
What's your graduation cap say? To God be the glory.
Yeah. To God be the glory.
It's hot down.
What is your addiction?
It's porn, isn't it? Not today.
Corn and porn sound too much alike. What is your addiction?
What is my addiction? Probably chicken wings.
I've been really addicted to Chick-fil-A lately.
That's like all things chicken.
I love Chick-fil-A. I like love it. I literally love Chick-fil-A. I'm finna take this wig off. Y'all finna see the real me. If you need to spend your life in one place for the rest of your life, where would you spend it at?
Walmart.
Well, mine was just gonna be Polk County.
Oh, dang. We could do that? I guess Florida then. Dang it. I was just saying Walmart because they got everything.
What makes you angry?
My baby dad.
I got my
sand
and cooking my stuff.
I'm saying. Her baby daddy makes me angry.
You are the real nigga. Yeah.
She's talking about my baby daddy.
Mine was already clean. I'm proud. Still. Really
nigga. Still.
Really
nigga. Edgy, this
is going to
be fun.
Name one movie or TV show that's really watched by everyone that you haven't seen.
Game of Thrones.
Color Purple.
I'm not TV.
It's that one movie or TV show.
Oh.
I've seen bits and pieces of the Color Purple, but it's just so like.
Nah, seen that today. I just ran it back.
I've seen Baby Boy, but I can't tell you what it's about because I don't think it has a meaning.
Oh, and Stranger Things. I tried to watch the first episode 5 times. I couldn't get past it.
Oh, it was good. I'm nosy, so I wouldn't know what's gonna happen. So then,
I can't. Oh, so, I mean, I like weird stuff. But like,
you definitely like weird stuff. She likes Narnia and stuff like that.
I watched all of those and read the books.
So I'm sure you have.
It's so fun. What happens to me?
But listen, I used to like Harry Potter, but then I grew out of it.
Harry Potter. Whoa. Wait a minute. You're not gonna get him too much.
Witchcraft.
I told my teacher, my mama didn't appreciate it. I mean, it didn't like witchcraft, so I didn't have to watch the movie. So he let me sit in his office.
I had to say the Pledge of Allegiance. Mama said it was against my religion.
Did it?
No.
Does your mom stand up for the
Pledge? No.
Yes, she does.
She doesn't.
I don't either.
When she started this.
Honestly, yeah, I don't think I can recite it at this point. I don't even remember it. Yeah. I haven't said it in so long.
I can say it in Spanish. I'm here.
Sure.
Juro fidelidad. What? Juro fidelidad a la bandera de los Estados Unidos de América y a la República representa una nación bajo Dios indivisible con libertad y justicia para todos. What?
1 year and champions.
What did you recite?
For the religious respect.
How are we supposed to know if she left?
She don't know.
Yeah. She just. Juro fidelidad a la banderos de los Estados.
But they're Castro.
Not right now.
It means the pledge of allegiance.
No, but.
What is that? The laws again. I
don't really know what you're saying.
Yes, I do.
Listen.
I'm calling. I pledge of allegiance. Una.
So all that means. I pledge of allegiance.
I pledge of allegiance. Una.
Una.
Una, una, now nah, I'm messing up because y'all. Is this thing hot?
What?
Is this thing hot on my legs? Like,
nah, that's what happens when you lie. You get hot when you lie.
What's a current trend you don't like and why? I don't like finger waves. People be getting finger waves. I don't like them. I don't know if that's a trend, but if y'all got finger waves, please stop. Today,
I don't like the finger pads across the chest.
Girls are supposed to wear that across your chest.
I don't like when the guys do it.
Yeah, I don't like when the guys do it either. It's like a purse. Might as well get a crossbody purse. You need to spend $500 in 8 hours. What do you do? Pay my car payment.
Period. And still need to borrow some.
But in a store, for real. What store am I going to?
I'm going to Ulta. That's it.
It depends on what I need. Like, if I need makeup, I probably go to Ulta, Sephora. If I need clothes,
either Ulta, or Jimmy Jazz, Foot Locker, Champs, what have you, I'm there.
Oh, well, it says I have $500 to spend in 8 hours, so don't give me a specific store. So, yeah, I go spend a little bit on makeup.
A little bit.
Some on clothes.
For sure, you spend... You get one outfit and some makeup, you out of money. That's that.
Mm-hmm.
Next question.
If you could be an animal for one day, what would you be? I want to be like an animal in somebody's house so I can see what they be saying about me.
I'm going
to
be a fly on the wall.
Flies get dead. I mean, flies die. I don't want to die one day.
You only die if you get caught.
I'll probably be like a dolphin or something.
Oh, you want to swim?
Yeah, I'm a Pisces.
Mm-hmm. I'd probably be like something like a little dog or something.
A chihuahua.
A little bougie dog, you know, that got the car seat and stuff. Oh, is there something you've done in the past and you wish you could go back in time and undo? Woo!
Hey,
man. Honey, you know where to start.
I'm sorry. I would go back to college and I would actually major in something that I actually like. I did criminal justice because my guidance counselor at the time, she told me that was the easiest major, and being like 18, I'm like, okay, easy, okay. And halfway through, I didn't want to do it anymore, and so I got a degree that I don't even use, and I'm paying back student loans, and that's a waste of my time. Also, never mind, I say that for another day.
Run it back.
Run it back.
Speak your piece.
What would you have gotten your degree in?
Probably education. It doesn't matter what you told me.
Hold up.
People gotta make their own decision.
I probably wouldn't have started this NBA. I would just kept my little bachelor's and kept it moving.
You can always quit.
Nah, I already started, not even a quitter. But
ain't no quitter, but don't push me. Hey, that's all.
It's a lot more than I expected.
If you could change the way school works, what would you do? First off, started like in middle school, I would make the kids like take like some type of test to see what they actually want to do with their life. and whatever they want to do, have classes geared towards that and information towards that. So say somebody wants to be a business major, an entrepreneur, or something like that, I would make them go to classes. Like their reading class would be talking about entrepreneurship and starting a business and stuff like that. Because teaching them about like Christopher Columbus and like stuff that they don't really care about is not benefiting them during this time. I mean, it was all cool when we did it, but it's kind of like outdated now. I know they have to learn about history, but it's kind of like pointless to teach them stuff that is not going to benefit them. It's too many kids coming out of high school that have no idea about credit, no idea about, how to buy a house, how to buy a car. Like, they don't know that kind of, those kind of things. And I feel like the school system should, like, teach them stuff like that, you know? But not everybody's going to college. My mama on the sideline, she said they need to go to school for 4 hours a day, which is true.
8 to 12 and then a 12.
But their mamas be at work, so they gotta be somewhere.
It don't matter.
Man, I'm about to say,
high school, because it's too long. Because they get bored. You get bored at work after so many hours.
You don't pay on that.
Heck no. All this integers and stuff like that, you don't ever use that in life. I ain't never used Pythagorean theorem since I've been older.
You gotta get through college though. You need it for college. You need it for college.
Photo man.
If you ain't going to college, don't worry about it. Quizlet.com. Ooh, baby. That's how I got my degree now.
What were you saying?
I would incorporate recess if we gonna be there for 8 hours. I'm saying like a brain break in the middle of the day, every day.
My students told me in Puerto Rico they get an hour break, like an hour recess break after lunch.
They got to. They need to.
All right, so the question was, what do people think of you, but that's not actually true? I said people think I'm smart just because you went to college, but just because you go to college doesn't make you smart. Or some people automatically look at me and think I'm stuck up, but I'm really not. I'm really not a stuck up person. How am I a stuck up person?
Who are you talking to? You asking me?
Yeah.
I didn't say it.
So why are you laughing?
Because they're explaining.
You don't think I'm down to earth?
Nope. Only because we know you, but you can't lie and say if you seen somebody you knew in the mall that you would speak.
You wouldn't either.
They asked me the question yet. You said that. I didn't say that.
It depends on what day it is, if I feel like speaking or not. That don't make me...
That's stuck up.
That don't make me stuck up if I don't want to speak. But like, if I see you and you see me looking back at you, then I'm like, hey. But if you don't see me and I don't feel like speaking, I'm just going to go.
Sounds about right.
But everybody has done that, so...
Done. You continue to do it.
So? Yeah, if you... Like, some days you just don't feel like speaking. You be like, hey,
let's see you. You
gotta
speak.
Right. You be like, let me go in here and I don't want to see nobody I know. And if you see somebody you know and they'll see you.
I'm not saying you gotta go out of your way to speak to somebody, but I've had somebody tell me that they saw you, made eye contact, and you still didn't speak.
Who, grandma?
No.
Let me sip my strawberry tea. What's one thing people think about you, but it's not really true?
People think I'm unfriendly. No, that's true. I don't know. I guess people think I'm soft too, though, because they be trying me.
If you could be born again with the same knowledge you have now, what would you do differently? Whoo, child. Okay. I'll let you go first.
Don't put him on child support. Run.
What she said. Run,
and don't look back. Only because child support like ties you to somebody for those 18 years. It's not optional after that. That sounds messed up, but it is what it is.
I would say live your life to the. I would be living my life to the fullest. I was like too hurrying to like to grow up. Like I was in college trying to like
bet.
Grow up, you know, like I was didn't really sit down and really like enjoy it, so I would go back and like enjoy it because now I look back, I'm like, dang, college wasn't that bad. I mean, I got homesick, but it wasn't that bad. I could have enjoyed it a little bit better. Or I was in high school and I would leave at 10 o'clock And all my friends would be having fun our senior year at school doing stuff and like hanging out, and I was at work because I was trying to make money and I don't know.
And you didn't even go to prom this senior year.
I didn't go to prom, but that was by choice. It was stupid. So yeah, I would just like live life to the fullest and not be trying to rush and grow up, you know. Are you close to anyone that you initially disliked?
Yeah, the both of y'all.
Oh, you don't like us?
I love y'all. But if I didn't know y'all, I'd be like, y'all up in it.
You? I don't really hang out with anybody I don't like, and I don't associate with people I really don't like. If I don't like you, family included, like, I don't even hang out with you. Are you most likely to engage in conflict head on or avoid it?
I ain't gonna avoid it, but I'm not gonna confront you either.
I avoid it. I don't like to argue. I don't have time. I don't like to raise my voice. I don't have time.
I ain't gonna raise my voice, but I ain't gonna buck back either.
I don't have time. I just cannot argue. I mean, I may send a little nasty text, but after I send it, don't send me nothing back, so I'm done.
Well, they ain't gonna have no chance to send it because you blocked.
Yeah, I'll be
blocked. But he ended up giving it free because they found no dead bug, so he just threw that in.
Are you satisfied with how you spend money? And what would you change?
I would change everything.
The jacuzzi won't come on without the heat.
I'm not satisfied, but I don't know how people save money.
Huh?
I don't know how people save money and still do what they want to do. Because if I save money, like, I put so much money aside from this check,
the day that you want
to
use,
and I'm so tempted to go in my savings account and pull it out and spend it because I feel like now I'm going to be broke. So, you got a debit card. I don't know how people save and do what they still need, like, they got to do. Like, I remember I was in high school and this girl came up to me. We worked at the same place. She goes, if I don't have $500 in my checking account, I feel broke. I'm like, sis, if I have $5, I'm rich because I'm going to McDonald's, getting me a large sweet tea and a double cheeseburger. And she was saying $500, and we were just in high school then, maybe 11th grade. So I don't know. I need help saving because I don't know how to save.
Now if my checking account is at like $500, I'd be like, all right, I need to slow down because payday until like another week and a half. But I'm probably still going to spend it.
Yeah, I don't know how to save. I feel like I need to live my life while I'm alive. Because what if I die tomorrow? Who I'm saving it for? Somebody else going to get to spend my hard work.
What if you live to be 100? Then what? Who you saving it for?
Capital warm me up then.
Oh my God. Okay. No, but it's like old ladies at my job that can't even retire because they didn't save up. Mm-hmm. And then they can't retire because they waiting on Medicaid. Like, they really out here struggling. So I got to get it together.
What's one thing you can cook good?
One thing I can cook good. I can bake. Does that count, baking? Because I can bake my dad's 100 pound cake.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
By yourself?
Yeah.
That recipe?
No. How is that not? I'm still doing it. What is that? Since that
I thought you knew, like, you know, something.
I mean, I know how much goes in there, but. I still need that. I don't want to mess it up.
I can make the best spaghetti slash baked ziti. I think it's pretty good. I think I mastered it so far.
I think your tacos are good.
Really?
Yeah.
Good idea.
After a divorce, would you rather share custody or get full custody? That's a weird question.
What?
After a divorce, would you rather get shared custody or full custody? That's a weird question.
It is a weird question. Oh, that's cute. Wow. That's bittersweet because you want full custody so you don't have to deal with all the BS. But then shared custody gives you a break because just when you think you're about to snap, it's time for them to go with their other parents.
I feel like if I'm getting a divorce from the person, they're crazy. So that means I want my full custody with my kids so we don't got to deal with the crazy.
I see no lies in that from experience.